Good morning to all my dear students. Once you all are being welcome to my class. Yes, today we are going to learn about monocot leaf next to dicot leaf. Yes, in unit 12, plant anatomy and plant physiology. Today's topic is internal structure of monocot leaf. Internal structure of monocot leaf, isobilateral leaf, example, crab's leaf. The transverse section of a monocot leaf reveals the following structures. Internal structure of monocot leaf, isobilateral leaf, iso which means equal, bi means two, lateral means sides. The transverse section or cross section of a monocot leaf shows the below three structures. They are epidermis, mesophyll and vascular bundle. First one is epidermis. Epidermis, monocot leaf has upper and lower epidermis. Epidermis is made up of parenchyma cells. Cuticle is present on the outer wall. Stomata are present on both upper and lower epidermis. Some cells of upper epidermis are large and thin wall. They are known as bulliform cells. Epidermis. Monocot leaf has upper and lower epidermis. Epidermis is made up of parenchyma cells. Cuticle is present in outer wall. Stomata is present on both upper and lower epidermis. Some cells of upper epidermis are large and thin-walled. Therefore, they are known as bulliform cells. Dear students, monocot leaf has dash and dash epidermis. As usual, ma'am will ask one more questions only. So, now itself, I'll just make through it. Okay. Monocot leaf has dash and dash epidermis. Yes, upper and lower epidermis. Dear students, in this paragraph has three one mark questions. Monocot leaf has dash and dash epidermis, upper and lower epidermis. Okay. Epidermis is made up of dash cells. Parenchyma cells. Stomata is present on both upper and lower epidermis. Dash is present on both upper and lower epidermis stomata. Some cells of upper epidermis are large and thin walled. They are known as dash cells, bulliform cells. Okay. Second one is mesophyll. It is the ground tissue that is present between both epidermal layers. Mesophyll is not differentiated into palisade and spongy parenchyma. The cells are irregularly arranged with intercellular spaces. These cells contain chloroplast. Dear students, mesophyll, it is ground tissue that is present between both epidermal layers, lower epidermis and upper epidermis. Okay, mesophyll is not differentiated in monocot leaf. The cells are irregularly arranged with intercellular spaces. Okay, these cells contain chloroplast, green colored plastids. In last class, we have learnt dicotyledon. No, there is the mesophyll divided into two. One is palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. But in this monocotyledon has different, not differentiated. Okay, listen, my dears, not differentiated from what? Palisade and spongy. Okay, in this paragraph, shall I ask some one more questions? Okay. Does the ground tissue that is present between both epidermal layers, mesophyll is the ground tissue that is present between both epidermal layers. Okay. The second question, mesophyll is not differentiated in two dash and dash parenchyma. Just now I said to you, mesophyll is not differentiated into dash and dash parenchyma, palisade and spongy. The last question, in mesophyll cells contain dash chloroplast. Answer is chloroplast. Okay. Finally, vascular bundles. Large number of vascular bundles are present, some of which are small and some are large. The third one is vascular bundle. Many vascular bundles are present. Many vascular bundles are present. Some vascular bundles are large and some are small. Some vascular bundles are large in size and some are small. Okay. Each vascular bundle is surrounded by parenchymatous bundle sheath. Vascular bundles are conjoined, collateral and closed. Xylem is present towards upper epidermis and phloem lies towards lower epidermis. As usual, each vascular bundle is surrounded by parenchyma bundle sheath. Bundle sheath are layer. These are conjoined, which means combined, collateral which means secure and closed. This is very very important words. Okay. Xylem present towards upper epidermis. Listen my dears, xylem lies towards upper epidermis and phloem present towards lower epidermis. Both xylem and phloem lies and present as same as dicotyledon. It is very very important. Both xylem and phloem lies and present as same as dicotyledon. Okay. First one more. Each vascular bundle is surrounded by dash. Parenchymatous bundle sheath or layer. Each vascular bundle is surrounded by parenchyma bundle sheath or layer. Xylem present towards dash epidermis. Xylem lies towards dash epidermis, upper epidermis. Phloem present towards dash epidermis, lower epidermis. Okay, my dears?
Good.
Last one is differences between of dicot and monocot leaf. Dicot leaf, monocot leaf. Tarsi ventral leaf, isobilateral leaf. Mesophyll is differentiated into palliser and spongy parenchyma. Mesophyll is not differentiated into palliser and spongy parenchyma. It is very very important. 2 mark question. Both sides of leaf shows different characters. Tarsiventral leaf, isobilateral leaf. Both sides looks like same aperture, but tarsiventral, already said you, tarsi, which means front, ventral, which means back. Iso which means equal, bi means two, lateral means sides. Okay, then second point is, dear students, the first point, tarsiventral leaf. Tarsiventral leaf, which means both sides of leaf shows different characters. Tarsiventral leaf means both sides of leaf shows different characters. Isobilateral leaf, which means both sides looks like same aperture. Looks like same aperture. The second point is, mesophyll is differentiated. Mesophyll is differentiated. We knew very well. That is what palisade and spongy parenchyma. Okay. Mesophyll is not differentiated. Okay. Into two types. Namely, palisade and spongy parenchyma. What is tarsiventral leaf? Both sides, tarsiventral leaf means both sides of leaf shows different characters. What is isobilateral leaf? Isobilateral leaf means both sides look like same aperture. Listen, my dears, transverse section of monocot leaf. See, the transverse section of monocot leaf reveals the following structures: epidermis, mesophyll and vascular bundle. First one is epidermis. Epidermis has upper epidermis and lower epidermis. Okay, the epidermis is made up of parenchyma cells. Parenchyma cells. Epidermis has made up of parenchyma cells. Cuticle is present on outer wall of stomata. Because the both sides upper and lower epidermis are present. Some cells of upper epidermis are large and thin walled. They are known as bulliform cells. They are known as bulliform cells. Second one is mesophyll. Mesophyll is the ground tissue that is present between both the upper and lower epidermal layers. Okay. Mesophyll is not differentiated. My dear, it is very very important. Mesophyll is not differentiated into palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. Palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma. Okay. The cells are irregularly arranged. The cells are irregularly arranged with intercellular spaces. Intercellular spaces. These cells contain chloroplast. Which cell? Mesophyll cells contain chloroplast. Mesophyll cells contain chloroplast. Okay. Third one is vascular bundle. Vascular bundles, large number. Listen, my dears, in dicot leaf, only one vascular bundle, less than vascular bundle we studied, no? But in monocot leaf, large number of vascular bundles are present. Some of which are small, see here, some are just small. And some are large. Okay, each vascular bundle is surrounded by parenchymatous bundle sheath. Parenchymatous bundle sheath. Vascular bundles are conjoined or combined. Collateral, which means secure and closed. Okay, xylem. Listen, my dears, xylem lice are present from where? Upper epidermis. Okay, xylem lies towards upper epidermis, and phloem lies towards lower epidermis. See the blue color. Okay, lower epidermis. Phloem lies towards lower epidermis. Take skim notes and study each and every lines to answer the 1 mark questions. Okay, thank you.